Welcome to the Totally Awesome Fishing Show, the greatest fishing show on YouTube. And I'll tell you what, I think we're going to put these out of business. I don't think you need to. Do you need to read any books? We're giving you guys the best information we can. And episode, whatever it is, 954. Here, we're going to be talking about, well, one of my favourite techniques. Now, it's a variation on the most famous pike fishing method I think that probably anybody's ever seen on YouTube. The deadly, totally awesome twitch sprat. We must have given that method more publicity than anybody's done in 100 years. And it's a good technique. But in a variation of it as well, using a float, is twitching floats. And I'll tell you what, it's good for distance fishing, medium range, and it catches fish. Let's go and look at some floats, and I'll tell you how to set up. Well, now, it's exactly the same technique as twitching a sprat, except you're going to be suspending your bait with a float like this. Now, what you need, in my case, is a pair of glasses. In my case, it's not just my driving glasses, it's my reading glasses. No, sad getting old, isn't it? I need my fishing glasses. Okay, so what we need is 3 pairs of glasses, and I'm using, no, I'm only joking, guys, I'm only joking. My eyes are bad, but they're not that bad. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna be using these Partridge VB hooks that we've always mentioned before. You can use trebles with this, I don't like using them, but because we're going to be using sardine, which is a much bigger bait, because we're going to be casting a lot further, going to be perhaps fishing a little bit deeper as well, I'm going to be using a size 2 in this, a size 2 VB hook, and I'll show you the reason for that in a minute. And the usual, I'm not even going to plug the make, it's old, it's probably out of date, is 40 pound test wire. That's what I use. Do not use single strand wire. I don't like it, it kinks, it can break. Eventually, it will break. So I use this multi-strand. That's in green, it's for sea fishing, it's for cutting through the depths when you're fishing a big lead in a big tide. That's all you need. You need some split shot, you've got your standard rod and reel. We might take a couple extra rods if we go fishing. 12 foot standard carp rods, I'm not big on these long rods, I like fishing short rods, but you will cast a little bit further out, you know, if you've got a longer rod. Basically, obviously take your own hooking mat and always get yourself maybe a couple of 3 pairs of these long nose forceps with a curve, artery forceps, because they're dead handy for rolling the hooks out. And remember, these hooks are much easier to get out than a treble. Okay, let's check out the floats. Standard float is a waggler float, a pike waggler float. Now, there's loads of people making all these different floats. Now, I'm not even going to mention the name. They don't do me any favours. I don't get any free ones. Why should I give them a plug? I've had them years. I think I found these in a car boot. But that's a waggler, so that's attached bottom end only with a locking shot. Now, you can put the weight for this. This would probably take about four swan shot. It's a big float. If you put near the hook the swan shot and you bulk it right down, either on the swivel or near the hook, that's going to take the bait right down deep. Now, it's not going to be twitching right. It's going to be sort of too over heavy. So what I like to do is just put one swan shot down by the bait, which, you know, the bait sinks down like this, and then I bolt the other shot up around the bottom of the float like this. So the bulk of the casting weight and the bit that cocks the float is up here high, and it just seems to twitch better. I don't like a lot of lead down near the bait. Okay, now these are some floats. You can make your own pike floats. You don't have to go buy anything. You can make your own. These were sent to us, a guy sent them in. We don't know who, no, he didn't even send us a note. He sent it to Totally Awesome Fishing. He's even painted on the bottom, TA Fishing on there. And they work. You can make them out of dowel, you can make them out of balsa, and you can put rings at the top, rings at the bottom. You can make them a bottom end only, drill them out, put a barrel swivel in there as well, glue it in, super glue it in, or Araldite, and make your float, paint them what colour you want. Okay, you've also got a sea float here. Now, it looks a bit chunky because years ago they used to use those really big round, they were called fishing gazette bungs. Now, that circle, when it's sitting on the water, creates a lot of resistance to pike. Don't get me wrong, a lot of guys caught a lot of big pike on those, and they probably still do now. But I don't want to drop any runs, I don't want any takes, any strikes, any pike. I don't want them dropping the bait if we can help it. So I don't like that area of resistance. This float will probably take the same amount of lead as a fishing gazette, but as you can see, it's a lot smaller to slip down through the water when the pike takes. You've also got standard ones. If you're using something like a twitch sprat, you can use these clear floats. Now, The float really is just to suspend the bait. That's all it is. I'll tell you why. If you cast a twitch sprat out a long way, you've got to keep the rod up high to keep it coming at a preset depth. Now, with a float like this, any of these floats, in fact, the bait is going to sink down. Big float, big bait, sardine. It's going to sink down. I'm going to twitch it, but I'm twitching it sort of upwards because the float's creating a different angle than if I was going down through the water with no float at all. I'd be going too deep. So it's going to bring the bait up at an angle. It's going to flutter up, fall down, flutter up and fall down. So you can use any of these. And this one I've got top and bottom. You can put it bottom end only, but I've got it top and bottom. And I can either tie, you know, just a little stop knot on there, or just to show you here, I've got like a BB shot there. I can preset the depth I wanted to go at. Now, the most important thing. This is the totally awesome secret. Nobody's around. There's only the cameraman. I know him well. It's called a popping cork. It's disgusting. I've had it years. I've got through about 6 or 8 of these. They're polystyrene and they come with a peg, and we use them tarpon fishing in the Florida Keys. You've got a split in them. You slide your line into the split. You push the peg in. Left, voila, that's it. And you can slide it up and down. I've even spray painted this one yellow, sort of vomit yellow, I'd call it. And I've got a little shot there because it's been used so long, that's got worn out a little bit. BB shot there, I can stop it at what depth I want. Now here's the most important thing, guys. Rounded, 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 concave. Why is that? Well, it's not because some wacko American just made a float and thought, oh, it's concave. It's called a popping float because when you jerk that through the water, it's polystyrene. That is exactly the same scoop as a popping plug, surface plug. And if you pop that through shallow water especially, that popping action will attract the pike. And don't forget, as you pop it, you're also tweaking 3 or 4 feet behind it, your bait. So there you go. Several sections of floats there, homemade, shot ball, and the deadly popping plug. Well, it's a plug, it's a float really. It's popping, and trust me, it does work. Okay, let's put the bait on. But I've changed my normal twitch bait rig, slightly extended with big hooks. We'll get the sardine, we'll show you how to put it on. Oh dear. I made a bad mistake, guys. I put this in the microwave on pretty near full power, trying to thaw it out just to show you. And it hustles. That is a partially cooked sardine. But let's show you anyway. Oh, dear. Okay, guys, now this is why I make a different rig. Obviously, a sardine is much bigger than a sprat. So therefore, if you watch some of our previous pike trace making videos, you'll see I'm fishing basically one hook in the head and one halfway down the body. Sardine is much bigger than a sprat. Therefore, I've extended it. Now, because we're going to be whacking the bait and cast them a little bit harder, I've increased the hook sizes here. Size 2 is plenty big enough for anything. And you can put a treble on the back here. I've got some rigs made up of here already if we go fishing with a treble on the back. But I really don't like using a lot of trebles. They're a pain to get out of the fish and they're an absolute pain to get out of the net. And quite honestly, guys, we rarely lose fish, you know, using singles, big singles, especially these doubles like this. They're good. So what I do is actually, I'll show you, I come around sideways. I can't bear touching this sardine. Should be eating it. Okay, so what I do is, and this is the most important thing, same as a sprat, this, in big game fishing terms, is called the throat latch. You need to pin both jaws closed. You don't want it open like that, because if you hook just through the top lip there, or the top jaw, there's going to be like a drag area in here, and when you twitch the bait using the float, it's going to spin. It's not the same. You want it flat. So close that little hinge up there and put the big hook, not the small hook this time, the big hook, straight through the bottom of that throat latch, and you've got to crunch it right out the top of the head like that. But it's got to be right there in the central zone, my loves. Okay, so that's where it's hanging. You can see how it's nice and straight. Second hook, it's a VB, so it's got a small single and a big single. I pop it right in the back. Now that is so simple, it doesn't bear thinking about. And that is all there is to it. I put SSG, Swan Shot, whatever shot you want there, just to enable that bait just to sink down slowly through the water. Then it comes up here to the float, right? And as I pop the float like that, I'm twitching. I'm still doing that twitch technique. I'm twitching the sardine, but rather than twitching it low and getting caught in the weed, it's coming up sort of that up at an angle. Hard to describe, But when you use it, I'll tell you what, you can catch some fish on it. Now, I've done quite a bit of this twitching business. I can't stop. But if you give this a go, a lot of guys make a big mistake with sprats, sardines, herrings, all dead baits, natural dead baits. They leave them out, they cast them and leave them. They go to sleep, they put it in the buzzer. Well, Pike take them, of course they take them. They will take more if you twitch it, trust me. You can work two rods. One cast over here, one cast over there. Give it a twitch, put it down, bait runner on. Twitch this one, by which time that one has sunk back down. And you can actually work two rods like this till your arms drop off. And they probably will, because you'll be fighting some big fish. Mike's not done this technique before. We're going to try and catch him a pike, if we can, using this technique. And we're going to try and show you guys how you should work it. It's a totally awesome technique. It does work. Whether it's going to work today, I don't know. But we're just, we've got like 3 hours in an afternoon to squeeze a little bit of a session in. See if we can't show you. We might get lucky. We might catch a fish. And trust me, we're being honest. I only decided to do this morning. Let's get down the lake and see what we can do. So what we're going to be doing, we're going to be maybe working the float along the edge of these rushes here. Get them in tight. We've even got our search and destroy helicopter up in the sky over there. We're going to make a bit of a racket, we'll have to make do. So what we're going to do is trying to work out. Hang on, what, you got fish?
Yeah.
Already? Oh yeah, fish this time, yeah? Okay, hit him again,
yeah,
huh?
There's some.
Good man.
Got one on here, hopefully it won't come off. Yeah, there we see him.
Can you see him?
That as well, cool.
See him under the sun, under the...
Yeah.
Take your time with him.
Small one, but we'll have him. There we go, guys. Nice little pike on the sardine. Just twitching the float a bit every now and then.
And look how dark it is, the markings.
Lovely markings on it. Lovely markings.
And look at his big teeth, mummy.
Great fish.
That shows using a float can work. Still twitching a bait.
Yeah. Let's get him back in the water.
In the water, see if we get another one.
Right, guys, I've got a take here. I just had my first pike there, back then. Small one. I'm trying to go for the double. My biggest pike so far is only about 8 pounds on the River Stour, so let's hope, drag set, that we've got a better one on here.
Oh, yeah.
That was a better bend.
Oh, take your time with it. That looks a bit better.
There we go.
Jumper.
Bait's gone. He's only just... Get the net. Where's the net?
I see one of the VB hooks just outside his jaws. That's good news.
And we've got no net.
Well, what's new? It's totally awesome.
There we go. Totally awesome. Pike number two bites the dust. Totally toast. Let's get him unhooked. There we go, guys. Pike number two. On the sardine, on the dead bait. Gave it a little twitch, felt the bump, opened the bail arm and let him eat it. Because the sardine's quite a big bait. It's not like the sprat where you can strike a bit earlier. You've got to let him eat it. I mean, this is a small fish. So we gave him a few seconds to eat that sardine. And luckily, he was only just hooked in the top lip on the treble. So we were quite lucky to land this one. Good little fight though, the size, lovely markings on it. Let's get him back in the water.
Get your pike back in the water as soon as you can, especially in the summer, when the oxygen contents are low. They survive better in the winter, but look, they live in the water, not out of it. Let them recover in your landing net before you release them. By getting your BB hook through both jaws, you can cast that sardine quite a long way. Let the bait sink through the depths, and you know when it's at the right depth, as you can see the float start to settle in the water. Then tighten up gently and give your rod top a flick to twitch the sardine higher up in the water. This will make you flash and wobble like a real injured fish. Repeat the procedure, but you must give a good 10 second pause to let that bait sink down deeper. Often, the motion of the sinking is what entices the pike to strike. If they see it falling towards the bottom, they'll often rush in and grab it before it sinks into the weed. Many anglers using our twitch sprat method just cast out and then they just wind in. That's not the way to get the most hits. You must pause to allow that downward flutter and movement. And don't just cast out with a float and leave it there. That's the way to fall asleep and not catch a totally awesome pike. And when you do get a take, a quick check of the reel drag and you're ready to set the hook with a good strike.
Another fish, guys. Third one.
Sardine again.
Sardine strikes again.
We're going to be out sardines in a minute. I see the float.
I see the fish. It's a third pike of a similar size. But hopefully that double is out there somewhere.
Although I was getting great action, I lost several as I was winding down on the pike too slowly at the strike. They must have felt the resistance of my winding and started to spit the bait as I struck. It was a learning curve twitching a float, but the old man told me if it was a big one, I wouldn't miss it. Basically, if you miss a strike with a big sardine bait, it would probably be a small jack anyway. Well, that's what I was told. Probably to make me feel better. At long ranges, mono line also stretches more. Plus, our old 12-foot carp rods were a bit softer. But just look at the fabulous markings of this predator as it goes back. You can see how they hide behind the weeds to ambush baitfish. They could be in amongst the reed stems, under old lily pads, or right by the overhanging trees. They're like an army soldier in full camouflage gear. And if you were a baitfish, by the time you see them, it's too late. What a great fish.
Okay, well Mike got, as far as I'm concerned, totally awesome lucky. But you can see that method, twitching the float, sardines, it can be sprats as well, they're really good, you know what we're like with sprats, we're actually married to them. But I'll tell you what's better than sprats, guys, a natural dead bait. And we know a fishery where some were netted, and the dead stuff left over, we managed to get our hands on. And these are good for twitching as well, because they have a bigger body like a density, so they sink better. And all you need is the same float, just a float, stopped by a shot, wire trace, and on this one I'm going to be using just a single treble because I'm just going straight through the jaws. I'm going to close both lips, I don't want the lip open because when I'm twitching it, it'll spin and wobble too much. I want it coming fairly straight through the water. And these are partridge outbarbs, they're called partridge outbarbs. So just take it right through both jaws, close up both jaws like that, and I've got like a bit bigger than a BB shot there, just to let it, and I'm sinking raw with a float, and let's face it, that's what it is. We're twitching sprats, in this case we're twitching roach. But natural dead baits, if you can get hold of them, and I don't like killing fresh fish, these are just bycatches, so it's lucky. I'm going to be using these. Generally, I might do with sprats and sardines. As you can see, the sardines work. I just have a feeling, though, this is going to work as well. Let's get one out there, see what we can do.
I catch a lot of pike on saltwater baits bought from the supermarket, but there's no doubting that a sparkling fresh natural dead bait will send pike into a feeding frenzy. Let that bait sink, then start to twitch the float to make the dead bait rise up in the water. A pause, letting it sink, then twitch again. Just keep repeating the procedure. And always keep a wary eye in the margins, as they'll often flash out and grab the bait right at your feet. I'm telling you, ladies, a visual take from a double-figure pike just as you're about to lift the bait out of the water is the ultimate adrenaline rush. It's worth all those hours of constant casting. Just watch Mike twitching our totally awesome American popping float and see the take he gets. You can see how the method works. Wham! The pike grabs the dead bait and starts to peel out line and then sink the float. The most exciting sight for a pike fisherman. Give them a short drop back to take that dead bait. Then just lock and load for some rod bending action. Uh-oh, this is the one that got away. But Mike was soon back in action, float pitching, and this time a hard strike met with solid resistance. Keep plenty of pressure on the pike to help set the hook. They often clamp down on the bait with those jaws, but the hooks, they actually might be outside. There's no way of knowing just how good your hook hold is, but one thing is for sure, slack line with a weak bend in your rod is going to give that pike an advantage. Twitching a dead bait with a float enables you to cover a lot of ground. You can use a couple of rods each and work your way right round a lake, gravel pit or pond to try and get a bait in front of as many pike as possible. It's so much more visual and entertaining than just lying on a bed chair staring at some bite alarms. Those pike could well be hammering the bait fish just two swims down, but you'll never know if you have your baits just lying in one spot. But while you can use two rods on a still water, you can only float twitch with one rod on a river. But let me assure you, it can still be a devastating technique. Hard frosts are likely to kill off much of the bait fish activity, and that will mean the pike have slowed down as well. Try to pick a mild airflow, low cloud, with clear water from no rain, and you are then in with more than just a chance. A light breeze will put a ripple on the surface, and that's going to help as well. Those are my perfect float twitching conditions. And don't be afraid to ask any match or pleasure anglers if they are getting bitten off by pike. That will also save you time locating the most productive spots. The more casts you can put in during the day, the better your chance of a catch. And as with all fishing, you never really know what's on the other end. As that float sinks away, as Mike is about to show you. Remember the age-old saying, elephants eat peanuts.
Please stay on. Whoa, I see it! That is one big pike. Get in! Big thumbs up. Hold him up, Nathan.
This is a beast, then.
PB.
Oh, what? Look at that. Oh,
excuse the French ladies.
Jesus.
That is...
That's totally awesome right there.
That is a seriously big pike. That's got to be world doubles, isn't it, Nathan?
Absolute beast. Definitely my PB. My last PB was £8.
You've done that.
I've definitely done that. On the dead bait. Whoa. Hold on, let it settle.
16, 17, I reckon.
Hold on. 16 pounds, 6 ounce.
Woo, mama.
It's my PB. We came in for a double. We definitely got a double. Just so you know, I'm not lying. We're clear off the bottom.
Here it is. We don't need to lie, Tony, you're awesome. And it's thanks to Nathan for telling us where to cast.
Yeah.
He absolutely told us where to cast. What a fish. Let's get a still off that one.
Yeah. There we go, guys. £16.6 on the natural dead baits. Absolute beauty, look at the markings on it. Stunning fish. Just hitting the lens there. Let's go get him back in the water.
Oh. Awesome, totally awesome.
Right, guys, here we go. I think it's a sixth pike. You just see me with that monster. Net's broken as well. You see me with that monster just now. Got quite a decent one here, actually, as well. Light's getting bad, so we're gonna have to stop filming, which sadly means we also have to stop fishing.
I think we're at those dead baits as well. But does this method work, or does this method work?
It's totally awesome. Here we go. What a pike.
And he's off straight away. Gone.